I was 11 years old when my mom kicked me out of the house for the first time. It was a school day! The sun wasn't even out! So you know what I did? I took a shit in the front yard. And I smeared it on her house with a leaf! Fuck! And then I took my happy ass on a school bus with that fucking trash bag of my belongings and went to school. And I told all of my friends, naturally. I thought this was the best revenge. I thought this was a normal thing that happened between daughters and mothers. I got sent to the guidance counselor.
Story time.
So on New Year's, my friend and I went to a house party. And she ends up leaving to go to the bathroom. But when she comes out like 3 to 5 minutes later, she's just like, guys, help. So like, I look at her, I'm like, what's wrong? And she's like, shh, I broke the toilet. I follow her to the bathroom. The toilet bowl is filled to the rim with water. And there's just 3 pieces of toilet paper just chilling on top. And I'm like, what did you do? She starts freaking out. She's, the people before me didn't flush. I thought I was okay to flush, but it wasn't okay. So one of our other friends comes in, hears the story, and she's like, okay, hold on. I'm gonna go get the house owner. And my friend starts freaking out, being like, no, don't tell him. He's gonna kill me. Our friend gets him anyway. And he comes in unbuttoning his shirt. He's just like, did someone call a plumber? And then he sees the toilet.
So I was just getting my nails done, and while I was there, there was a baby screaming and crying because it was past her bedtime and she didn't want to be in the stroller, and the mother just kept apologizing to everybody in the building, saying, I'm so sorry, she should have been asleep by now, I thought she'd be asleep by now, I'm so sorry. So I had the guy hurry up with my nails so that I can go over there and introduce myself, let her know that I'm a mother of 2 boys, been there, done that, and let me help you. And she let me help her, so I held the baby while she finished getting her nails done. And whenever she was done, she's like, thank you so much, we're getting Christmas pictures done, so if we weren't doing that, getting my nails done wouldn't have even been on my radar.
Story time. I babysat a lot of kids in my neighborhood, and there was this one night that I was babysitting a 2-year-old. It was around 10 o'clock at night, so the kid was sleeping, and I was just sitting in the living room. In the living room, there was a big TV, a couch, and then behind me, it was a wall with a giant window. So it was really late at night, I had nothing to do, so I was Snapchatting my friends. If you Snapchat anybody, I'm sure you know that sometimes you Snapchat really fast. You don't even know or look at what you're sending. I was mass snapping all my friends, and then one of them replied 10 minutes later. And he said, who's that guy behind you? And I turned around and no one was there, so I'm like, he's playing a joke on me. But then I get another Snapchat from this friend I had, and she lives all the way across the country. They don't know each other. And she said, I think there's someone outside. So I was really freaked out because I was alone, there was a giant window behind me, apparently there was someone outside. I wasn't gonna call the child's parents because I didn't want to freak them out, but I was scared. So then I went around the house, locked all of the doors. Sorry, it's a really long story, like for part 2. Part 2. So there was a guy outside the window. So yes, I did lock all the doors and everything. I made sure everything was secure. I closed the blinds. So for the rest of the night, nothing else really happened other than this really weird thump. It was like someone was knocking on a window. Allow me to demonstrate. I ignored it because I was in denial that this was happening. The rest of the night was normal. The parents came home. I drove really fast home. And then the next morning I wake up. And apparently, an old man with Alzheimer's had escaped from his little home. I did not know this because it was dark outside, and even if I did see him outside the window, I wouldn't have known this. But he was naked. Naked. So it wasn't like a mass murderer outside the window, but it was a naked man with Alzheimer's looking at me through a window. It's not every teenage girl's dream, but it's really weird just knowing that a naked old man was staring at me through a window.
Story time about how a guy bothered me then got into a car accident. So basically I was just sitting in my car waiting for my food to get ready with my brother when I see a guy pull up with this car backing up to park in front of me. He backed up so fast where he almost hit my car. So me and my brother honked at him and we're like, yo, like, watch out, you're about to hit the car. And he gets out of the car and he's like, I have eyes, I can see, like, okay, you have eyes, but clearly you can't use them. So he goes inside the store to pick up his cake, and my brother goes inside to pick up our food. And by the time he comes back out, my brother's not back out yet, and I wanted to honk at him and be like, next time watch what you say. But he left, and then my brother came out right when he left and he was at the light. And I was like, listen, we're gonna go catch this guy and I'm gonna like beat him up. I mean, I really couldn't beat him up, but I just wanted to follow him, like give him the finger or whatever. So I'm driving and I feel like I lost him and I didn't find him, and I'm like, oh my gosh, no. And then I found him. I saw his car and I went after him, but like for part 2. Story time part 2 on how a guy bothered me, they got into a car accident. So basically, I was following him, and then I finally saw his car, and I was like, yes. I told my brother, I was like, I'm gonna honk at him, give him the finger. So he saw us doing that, and I was like, yes, like, I got my revenge. Like, I just wanted to do that to him because he was being a whole jerk. So I thought he was turning at the light and he was gonna go on his way, and I went on my way, and I was waiting at the light to make a U-turn to go back home. And me and I was just like, yes, like, that made my day, because he got tight, he couldn't do anything. And we're sitting at the light, and I see his car pull up and, like, next to us, and he's holding his middle finger up and looking at us. So as he's doing that, we're giving the finger back, and he's not even looking in front of him to see if there's another car. So right when he's looking and giving us the finger, he hits the car in front of him. Me and my brother were like, yes, you idiot, karma is a bee. That is what you get, Hante. So the guy got out of the car and he stopped.
I'm gonna tell you guys about the time that my entire class teamed up to take my teacher down. And by down, I mean fired, which is terrible, but... And to be clear, I wasn't involved in the incident. I was just asked in to be a witness along with the rest of the class. If you're not interested at this point, like, I don't even know. So when I was in sixth grade, I had this teacher called Mr. W. We're gonna call him Mr. W. He was our science teacher. And he was fine. He wasn't, like, amazing or bad. He was just okay. He did smell, like, really, really bad. But again, that didn't affect his teaching at all. One day, however, I don't even know how this happened. He asked us all to get started on our work. He was a little irritated that day. I don't even remember why. One of the girls in our class, her name was Summer, she didn't have her workbook. Mr. W asked her where her work was. I didn't bring it today. They started arguing. The rest of the class was kind of silent, just watching this. She's a nice girl. She wasn't attacking him or anything. He did, however, get very angry. So angry, in fact, that he grabbed his binder and threw it across the room over her head. It just barely skipped her head and slammed on the floor. This wasn't like an empty binder from the dollar store. It was a teacher binder full of work. We were all silent. Summer stopped talking. Look for part two. Okay, this is part two of my teacher almost getting fired. After that whole incident, my class was dead silent for the rest of the period. We then all went to lunch. None of us really talked about it, but then, all of a sudden, a woman came up to us. We were all kind of sitting around the same table. This woman, I guess she was administration. I have no idea who she was. I think what had happened was a bunch of students had reported him. She asked us all from Mr. W's class to follow her. I don't remember if this was the same day or the following day. She asked us to follow her into an empty classroom. I think it was used for testing. She had us all sit around the table and recount the incident to the best of our ability. Summer was there. What she wanted to know was basically, did Mr. W throw that binder at Summer? And we all recounted it basically the same, but at the end of the day, we all said yes. But eventually, they let us all go. The following day, Mr. W was really sad. Barely spoke to us, barely did anything. He was passing out some work. He looked at Summer and said, Summer, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to throw that binder at you. His voice sounded like he was about to break. But we did have him as our teacher for the rest of the year, so no, he wasn't actually fired. But I do think Summer was terrified to speak up for the rest of that year. And the rest of us kind of didn't want to be in that class anymore. Yeah.
Story time about how I found out that my boyfriend was trying to get with another girl on Valentine's Day. Okay, there's a lot that goes into this story time, so let me break it down for you real quick. I was a sophomore, and my boyfriend and I had been dating for about 4 months now. And he was a junior. Well, there was this girl that he was for some reason obsessed with in his Spanish class. She was a freshman. And I know you're probably thinking, oh, well, how did you know he was obsessed with her? Well, he would Snapchat this girl 24/7.
Even his friends told me he was obsessed with her.
So I talked to him and I told him I was uncomfortable with how much he was talking to this girl. And he said, oh, okay, I'm sorry, I'll block her. Now, I didn't ask him to do that, but it made me feel more confident in how he felt about me. Well, Valentine's Day comes around. And we didn't talk all day until he came to pick me up. I wished him a happy Valentine's Day and got left undelivered. So we get to the restaurants and we decide to put our phones at the end of the table so that way we would be more focused on each other. Well, he goes to the bathroom and then I see this name pop up on his phone. Like for part two.
Part two. So, like I said, I saw this name on his phone, and there was something special about this name. So, whenever I kept streaks, I would put the word streak, and then an emoji, and then the person's name. And he got the idea that instead of keeping her name, he would put it as streak. So I was like, that's really fucking weird. And at first I was like, what the fuck? So I opened his phone, and what do you know, it's from that girl. And she was replying back to a big paragraph that he sent her. And we had school that same day. So at 6:30 in the morning, this girl got a big paragraph from my boyfriend about how she's such a beautiful, amazing girl and that she deserves somebody who's gonna take her out and buy her flowers and stuff. And how if she wanted to go out to dinner, let him know. He took an extremely long time in the bathroom, so the waiter came to our table. So I ordered $300 worth of food for myself. So when he came back, I told him that I had to go call my mom, and I left. And he was stuck with a $400 bill.
Okay, story time. So I work at a jewelry store, and today a man came in looking for a gift for his wife for their 10th year anniversary. He ended up picking out a piece that said, "My beautiful wife." And I said, "Anything else for you today?" And he said, "No, that's it for her, but I do want to make another purchase using a separate credit card. And could you possibly create a different account for me?" And I said, "Sure, what are you looking for?" And he said, "Do you have anything that says girlfriend?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Perfect, I'll take it. And do you have anything that says happy 1 year anniversary to go with it?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Perfect, I'll take it." So I boxed everything up all nice and I put them in their respected bags. He had me mark a K for Kristen on the bottom of his wife's bag and an L for Laura on the bottom of his girlfriend's bag. I put pretty bows on them. I handed it to him.